I am going to solder and desolder this IPM and this air conditioner motherboard. But first, let me tell you why I am doing it. So the customer gave me this mini split air conditioner motherboard and told me its display shows an L4 error. So let's check whether this motherboard has any problem or not. First of all, I will check the motherboard physically. Whether it has any damage inside it or not. I have already checked this motherboard, and I didn't find any harm in this motherboard. I have set the multimeter on diode mode. I haven't passed any electricity through this motherboard. I will check it first without electricity. I have placed the black probe on the negative pin of the IPM on the high side. And the red probe on the positive pin of the IPM. The multimeter showed a voltage drop of 1.something volts, and then disappeared. And on the next pins, the multimeter should not show any kind of voltage drop. This pin shows a zero voltage drop on the multimeter. This means that the U pin of the IPM is problematic. It has been short-circuited. Now for making the IPM out of the motherboard. I have placed the motherboard on the PCB holder stand. It is easy to remove the IPM from the motherboard. I will pull the IPM with this puller. I will put the puller here with the IPM. I will rotate the motherboard now. If you want to remove the IPM easily from the motherboard, you should own a good quality soldering iron. I use a knife tip for soldering and desoldering components. Let me explain why I use this tip specifically. The bigger the tip, it will produce more heat, the more heat is produced, and it will be much easier to remove the IPM from the motherboard. Add new solder on the already soldered pins. Adding a reflow of new soldering in the old, already soldered pins makes the pins heat quickly and makes it easier to remove the component. I am equally heating the pins to remove the IPM from the low side. And see, pins have come out of the motherboard easily without breaking. Half side of the IPM has been easily removed from the motherboard. I had no difficulty in doing it. The high side of the IPM sometimes is easier to remove. But most of the time, I use a technique to remove the IPM from the high side as sometimes it gets hard to remove the IPM high side. I will use heat air blow with the soldering iron. It gets much easier to remove and desolder the IPM from the motherboard. The IPM on the high side pins has started to melt and drop down from the motherboard itself. Now I am using a sucker to remove the solder left on the pads. This will make the holes clean up. Now I am cleaning the pads with petrol. This makes the removal of dirt from the soldering pads easier. Also, it makes holes in the soldering pads more visible. Now you can see the through holes have been cleaned, and the holes are clearly visible. From the other side as well. I finished the removal and desoldering of the IPM in 10 minutes. I am cleaning the front side of the IPM pads too. After cleaning it, I will align the new IPM in the motherboard. I have aligned all the pins on the low side according to the through holes. Now I am trying to insert the pins in the through holes. All the pins have aligned. If any of them does not align, then align with the through hole. And the pins have been inserted in the motherboard through a hole easily. In the same way, I will insert the pins of the IPM from the high side as well. I am aligning the pins using a scraper, and they have been inserted into the motherboard easily from the other side. After this, I have to hold the IPM so it may not fall. I am twisting the 2-3 pins of the IPM from here. 2 pins from here. 3 pins from here. And at last, 3 pins from here. Now I will fit the motherboard back on the heat sink, to align the IPM properly with the heat sink. The motherboard has been fitted. Now I will tighten one of the screws of the motherboard. After this, bring the pins back from the twisted position. To prevent the IPM from bearing any load by tightening the screws. Now the IPM has been touched with the heat sink. I will tighten the screws of the remaining components too. This way, all the components will be appropriately aligned with the heat sink because all these components attached to the heat sink should not have a gap between them. The components will heat up if any gap is present between these components and the heat sink. Now I will solder the IPM. Now all the pins of the IPM have been soldered. I am moving the soldering iron on these pins. This makes the solder clear up. After this, check whether any pin is joined with one another, because if any pin is joined with one another, the motherboard will go bad immediately. I use a magnifier to check this. All the pins are fine. No pin is joined with one another. This means the IPM has been soldered on the motherboard. I will now power on this motherboard. The electricity has started to flow through this motherboard. The LED lights are turning on and off. Now I will check the voltages on the IPM. The sensors are not installed in the motherboard, so the LED lights are blinking. When I checked the voltages on this pin when it was bad, this pin was 305 volts on the multimeter. But on this pin, 16 volts are flowing. The 15 volts were not flowing on this pin, which was faulty. Now I am checking the voltages on the next pin. The voltages on this pin are also fine. The voltages on the last pin are also fine. Always check the mini split AC motherboard with the multimeter without electricity. If it shows, everything is fine. Then pass electricity and check where the voltages are not passing. Then you can find and fix the fault easily. This motherboard is now fine. And no L4 error will be shown on its display. The L4 error on the mini split air conditioner also means that it is the IPM module failure error. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.